Welcome to the next video here by Howard Piano Industries. We're going to be continuing our study today on piano tuning theory and some of the things that you need to understand to tune a piano by ear and some of the theory behind how piano tuning is done. Here you're looking at, in our workshop, the string simulator that we've got. We're going to talk about partials today and what partials are and overtones are. When you've got in a piano, when you've got a string, you've got whatever the length of it will actually create not only the fundamental tone or the main pitch that you hear, but it will also generate what are called overtones or partials, which are higher notes that are higher than the fundamental note that are generated by segments of the length of the string. Okay, so for example, this string right here is 25.5 inches, and the whole length of that string will generate the tone of middle C. Okay, if I play that, the main tone that you hear in that note is going to be middle C or the C4. Okay, and you can do this on any note, but if you cut the length of that string in half, and I'm just going to put my ruler here to cut, essentially make a termination point for the string, and then pluck the string so that I've only playing half of the string. Let's try that again. Okay, if you can tell, that's one octave higher. Okay, and that would be what's called the second partial. The first partial would be the fundamental tone. The second partial would be if you divided the string in half. Okay, and that note, an octave higher than the middle C or C5, is actually generated when you play C4. The third partial is if we were to take the length of the string and divide it by 3. Okay, and I've got it marked here so that I can play. It's actually an octave and a fifth above the fundamental tone. Okay, so the fundamental tone is middle C. The second partial is an octave higher, C5. The third partial is an octave and a fifth, perfect fifth. Okay, so that would be G5. Going on to the next partial, if we divided the string into 4 equal parts, okay, then we're going to go to 2 octaves above the fundamental note. Okay, so that's, you got middle C, C5, and C6. Okay, and I'm just going to do one more as an example here. This would be the fifth partial, and dividing the string into 5 parts. Okay, this is going to be actually 2 octaves and a major third above the fundamental tone. That one's a little bit harder to hear, but it's there. If I play that same note on the piano, okay, you can hear that in that tone there. So that's 2 octaves and a major third above the fundamental tone, which would be E6. Okay, because we had C4, C5, C6, and then that would be E6. So those, and then in the next section of this video, we're going to be showing you how that actually translates to the piano and demonstrate how those tones are present in the overtones and the partials are present in any single note. Now here we're in front of the piano where we're going to demonstrate these partials or overtones that we've been talking about. Here we've got middle C right here. Okay, and we're going to start with that. Now to demonstrate, and you can try this on your own piano, if you go and you press the note down, and you can do this on any note, you know, I'm just using middle C as an example, but if you go and press the note down without it striking the string, which means you got to just push it down real slowly and let it rest there and hold that. And the reason I do that is so that it raises the damper that particular note. I mean, I could push the damper pedal down, but that would raise all the dampers and would skew our results here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly hit strike the C above it, which is, like we talked about, the second partial, which would be the first overtone. And you can hear the note vibrating in this string for the middle C. Because if I let go of the middle C, that stops. Okay, I'm going to show you one more time. Okay, so you can tell that C5 is actually vibrating in the C4 string because it's one of the second partial. Okay, now we talked about the G5 as being the third partial, and we'll demonstrate that here too. Okay, so you can hear that G5. Okay, and then the fourth partial would be the C6. So you can hear that, and then the fifth partial that we demonstrated. That one's a little bit harder to hear. But it is there. And we could keep going up, as you might have noticed, and this is true, as the partials get higher, further away from the fundamental tone, they get closer together. So the first one was an octave, the second one was an octave and a fifth, the fourth one was two octaves, the next one was an octave and two octaves and a major third, the next one would be two octaves and a perfect fifth, and so forth. If we kept going up all the way up to the C8, which is the highest C on the highest note on the piano, we would find that the C8 is actually the 16th partial that's generated by C4, okay, or middle C. So they get closer together, and we'll try to get a list and table of partials available here for you. On our website, if you go to our howardpianoindustries.com, which is our website. So this is the next step, and continue watching as we bring you more videos on piano tuning theory. Please let us know if you have any questions.